Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Talena, your favorite goddess, and welcome to Tal's World. In this video, we are going to look at the unexpected prizes coming your way. I'm excited about this read. Please choose your pile. This is for entertainment purposes. Yeah, if you want to skip to your pile, do that. But I'm going to do a little talking spiel. I'm going to do Tal Talks. Okay. I'm going to do a Tal Talk. First, I've recorded this video once already, so this will be my second time recording it, which is fine. The energy is different. It's a new day, whatever. And I'm tired of coming online and not being able to just be myself, regardless if I'm taking too long. Watch that shit in like times two speed if you have like problems watching things for long periods of time. Because I like to talk, you know. Also, I want to try to keep the readings at least 5 minutes or less. I don't know. I'm here to vibe regardless. Hello, pile number one. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to be looking at what are your unexpected surprises coming your way. So, I want to just say, looking at the picture, my nose might run this whole fucking video. It's perfectly fine, though. But, some unexpected surprises that's coming your way is a baby announcement. You could be pregnant. You could know someone who's pregnant. I don't know. But those daisies look like a baby contraption that you put on a crib, you know? So I love that for you. Whatever. Ooh. No. Okay. What was it saying? A surprise that be coming to you, have a cleanse that showed up. For a needing for you to purge. Purge of something. I also want to say that whatever unexpected surprise that's going to come your way, it feels very motherly and nurturing. Very in your feminine energy. So maybe there's a need to cleanse the feminine energy. That could be an unexpected surprise. Whatever it is, it has been in the dark for a minute. It's something that has been in the dark for a minute. That's why I'm really getting the pregnancy, because when in the belly it's like dark and shit. But I feel like it's something that you've been working on and now it's ready to come to light. Like if you know the Seven of Pentacles card, it reminds me of that card. Like they're tending to their garden for a long period of time and then their harvest comes about. That's the energy that it gives me. I have courage and time. Time like the seasoning, I guess. I don't really know. I don't use it clearly in my cooking, but I need to. You could be a Libra. Swords. There's also possible communication from someone. I need clarifiers. There's also possible communication with someone. Who is this someone that they're going to have some communication with? Huh. Whatever's coming in, it's not going to be so heavy. It's going to feel like fulfillment. I'm still a little confused about the pain and protection card. What have you been experiencing that's pain? Has someone passed away? Have you lost a friend? Have you gone silent? about something that you're working on, or have you gone silent? Are you doing like a silent pregnancy? Like, you're not letting people know? Because I fuck with you if you're doing that. I like a private life. Like, I'm not too much about like being in social media, though. Yes, we have a YouTube channel. Yes, da da da. But like, that's not my goal, is to be like that type of famous. Okay. We're going to keep that down, because, honey, you ain't going to stress me. So whatever is coming in, or the unexpected surprise, is a announcement of some sort that you are in control of. I think you have the surprise. It could be, like I said, you telling people you're pregnant or that you had a baby. It also could be simply you letting people know you've been working on a project. I hope you guys were able to hear me. You've been working on a project that is not ready to be seen. I really want to get like some more clarifiers, because I feel like there's something else missing. There's something else missing. We also got a lot of throat chakra energy. So a lot of blue energy. Are you ready for your blessing? Are you ready? Super coming out. So, I feel like there is something that you felt like you needed to keep quiet. I feel like there's something that you felt like you need to keep quiet, but in all actuality, you didn't need to if you didn't really want to. But just know that you being quiet has helped your protection. Though, what if you decided you wanted to be boastful about whatever you got going on, know that it was still going to happen regardless if someone tried to like put their energy into it. It was still going to happen. So no, you don't have to hide. I'm happy for you, for sure. But there's just some surprise that you're going to announce, or like it could be a new, not necessarily a new like job. It's some type of fulfillment energy. Some type of fulfillment where it could be financial fulfillment, but it also, I'm feeling more in regards to some idea that you had that manifested in reality. Like, so like the only one I'm thinking of is the pregnancy, but you don't have to be pregnant. Okay. I'm going to give you a self-care card for your 2024 vibes. Huh. Mind you, this is 2024. It doesn't have to be 2024. I'm just going to get the first card on top. Ground yourself. And it's 25. So it could happen in the summertime. This announcement could happen in the summertime. For now, I need you to ground yourself. I need you to take care of your roots. I believe that this energy is coming sooner than later. So right at 2024, not necessarily, but if you are watching this sometime throughout 2024, then you know it is what it is. But this message is still for you. Alrighty, yes, some good things are happening where you're gonna build courage to tell people something. So hope you liked this video. Please subscribe if you want to see more content like this. And I'm about to do another video with the same outfit on it. So you're gonna see another video soon. Bye bye. Pile number two, welcome back to my channel. We're going to look at what's coming to you in 2024. This is more of a shorter timeline, not necessarily like end of year type things. So something is dealing with your money. Something is happening with your money. Money, money, money. I feel like in 2024, you're going to become more clear about your finances. I am so sorry that that cut off. Something is growing. And I believe it's your finances in 2024. And it's coming soon. Looking at your picture, there's some prize that someone's about to gift you. There's something that someone's going to gift you. Obviously, it can be some flowers. But I don't think it is. Whatever idea you have, whether that's a business project or a project in general, doesn't have to, you know, revolve around business. Any idea of like home decor, if you want to move your room around because of feng shui or your house, whatever, do that. Whatever idea you have is going to help your productivity in 2024. Yeah, that's going to give you a cleanse. It's going to give you a cleanse that you've been needing and wanting to feel. I feel like something in your life is leaving. So, yeah. Something in your life is leaving. We have self-esteem. I possess gifts of the soul that benefit me and others. And then empath, I am open to seeing both sides of the situation. So, I want to get clarifiers about this, but look. Do you see that? That's root energy. That's dealing with family, homes, cars, material of any sort, watches. I want to know what that's about. I don't want to tap into the energy that's dealing with men, because that's not the goal here. That is not the goal here. Ooh. Okay. I don't have to tap into it. So I got this Two of Wands, and I got Justice in reverse, Magician in reverse, Six of Swords in reverse. So I am getting that someone is leaving in your life. It could be a male, but it doesn't have to be a male. It could honestly just be a woman of some sort. It's the need to take two different paths. Yeah. I think I want to get a self-care card. And that's just going to be your reading. These are my only intentions. And you're going to probably find someone that has a better intentions for the relationship. It's not going to be probably. You are going to find better for you. So we have flow like water, 24. So whatever happens in 2023 is going to allow you to have more free flowing energy. This also ties into the number 6, going back to Six of Swords. If we're in the upright, I want to actually look in the book about the Six of Swords. Times change with the rise of the tide, and right now you are doing your best to stay afloat. Change is not always easy, but this is necessary transition in your life. You are braving troubled waters to catch bigger fish in the sea, and new and strange environments may leave you feeling adrift, especially without your core humans and comfort of your home. Just know that you can always come home to yourself when you start to feel overwhelmed. Leaving home base always allows you to grow and expand in unexpected ways. Did we not just say this is unexpected? Okay. So, I guess, yeah, it was more home. Anyways, it says opportunities were limited in the past and you ventured off to new territory to better your future. New land means a new perspective. As environment shapes us into who we are, rather waves, it's easier to go with the flow than to resist. If it was in the upright, because mind you, this was not, if it's in reverse, I meant to say, because this was in the reverse, but this, yeah, so that's in good position. This is in bad position. This says, not necessarily bad position, it means stagnant, stuck, resistance. So it seems like whatever's going to be happening is going to get you out of this, but I'm going to read this. Self-sabotage is controlling your actions without you even realizing it. By repeating these behaviors, it keeps you stuck in the same place rather than moving forward. No matter how hard you try, the past keeps catching up with you, and it's self-defeating, to say the least. Carrying emotional baggage leaves you with heavy memories you cannot change, lingering onto the present and influencing the actions you take in the future. Fear of the unknown keeps you safe, even though it's stagnant. The Six of Swords reverse is a gentle reminder that change is good and encourages you to be brave during transition. It will open doors you didn't know existed, but you have to trust the process. Open yourself up and allow yourself to transition to a new place. Okay. So, like I was saying, whatever this was about, okay, I said that you were having lack of productivity, a lack of, like, yeah, there's two paths that you have to take. There's two choices you're going to have to make, stay or go. Stay or go, stay or go, stay or go. And the energy is given that you're going to go. Whatever idea, you're going to have to put some forward movement to it. And I think that's where this Ace of Wands is saying that it hasn't been putting in no one. I guess it could. You could be putting in motion, but it's not as it could be. Some illumination will come from that as you keep putting in motion and death of old things and then rebirth of new things. Hope you guys like this video, and I hope you guys like 2024. I will see you guys in the next video where I'll be dressed the same. Okay, bye-bye. Hi, guys. Welcome back to my channel. It's Talani, your favorite goddess, and I tend to do that a lot. I reintroduce myself. But welcome, pile number 3. What's going on? I want to tell you a couple things. First, your surprise could be a new home. Okay. Next thing is, you guys made me like my space. Like, something in regards to your home is being uprooted. Like, I lit this Palo Santo 3 times, and then I had to light my blunt because I wanted to smoke. But the way I was set up, it was like, I also lit my incense. Like, it was like you were telling me, like, bitch, get me right. And I was like, oh, okay, shit. I'll get you right, you know? So I want to say, in regards to your home, I mean, in the picture, you see that there is, you know, a couch and it's on some pillows, but I definitely believe it's more home aspect that will be coming your way. And then I was also listening to Lifestyle before this by Rich Homie Kwan. And that also gave me the vibes that maybe something in your lifestyle is just changing. lifestyle is encompasses a lot of things, but whatever it is, it's going to be fulfillment. We have the Ten of Cups here. If you've seen the Ten of Cups in other decks, that is a rainbow with a family under it. Like, it's that ultimate fulfillment. So whatever you've been manifesting, literally whatever's on your mind right now in this moment, is the surprise that's coming to you. So we have, this song is called Genesis by Daniela Andriade. But it says, everywhere I go, I grow. Even though it's gonna take some time. Diamonds are a little shy. See, this something about your lifestyle, baby. It's changing. It's changing, so you're going to have more clarity and desire for change in your life. You got Cancer. You can be a Cancer. You also can be a, fucking signs. I'm getting heavy Cancer, so you're definitely a water pile of some sort. I want you guys to eat more greens and veggies. I was going to look up the signs because I don't know what sign this is. So just listen to the music. I have 111. 3 could be significant. 'Kay. So it looks like you could be a Virgo. Okay. So now that we have that, and we understand that it's going to bring you so much love. You're going to feel love when you receive these things. Whatever is coming in, you're going to receive love. It's going to help you. It's going to help allow you to rest. Oh, flow. It's going to give you that happiness, and it's going to allow you to rest. What is this? You're the Magician. I don't need to look at that anymore to know what you're, what's unexpectedly coming in. If I want to get more clarifiers, let's get a clarifiers with this deck, actually. Can I get some clarifiers? Wow, number 3. What is transitioning in their life? I also feel like you're giving more luxury. So if you did not grow up with luxury, or if you're new to the luxury world, same, and so am I, you know, you're going to be experiencing more luxury, where luxury is, it's your best friend. Luxury is something you know. You're familiar with luxury. So I love that for us. We have pride. And some people might find it like, oh, she believes she has everything, da, 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 like nothing bad, da, 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 da. You know, like if that's what you want to think, you could think that, but like realistically, I'm just that girl and I work for what the fuck I got. Okay, so it says, I love myself and I see everyone, I see myself in everyone. Well, that's a fact. Like, that's I'm not trying to reflect negativity, but if you feel negative about my situation. Doesn't that sound personal? Doesn't that sound personal? It sounds personal. So let me get you a self-care card to see what you can be working on right now. Right now. And allow that manifestation, that luxury lifestyle, and elevation to come your way. All right. I want you guys to clean your space. Okay, that's easy. That's easy. That's easy, right? It's easy. And I also want you to have sex. You can pleasure yourself. Or you can have sex with somebody. If you do choose to do that, think about the soul ties that come with that. have fun. You know, I'm all for fun, but let's be responsible. Let's think about mind, body, and soul. Is this going to help you out, or is this going to stress you out? If it's helping you out and doing this job, have fun. So, yeah, 2024, those are your surprises for pile number 3. Bye.